Hello students, welcome back to your English class. I hope you all are fine and studying at home. Today, in our English class, we will study a new lesson. What do you observe in this picture, children? You can observe an art being done. So that there are different artworks we can do. The one who does the art is called as an artist. Unit 2, The Master Artist, written by Carol Moore. About the author. Carol Moore was born in the year 1871. She was an American educator, writer, and advocate for children's libraries. She is the creator of the site Children's Storybooks Online. She created the site to fulfill her lifelong dream of writing stories for children. She also illustrates stories for children. Carol Moore died in the year 1961. Learning outcomes. By the end of the lesson, you will be able to identify the cause and effect format of the story, explain how suspense is created and maintained, and the comic touch at the end. Express how the artist puts forth hit ideas boldly and with passion. Recognize the excitement of a master artist trying to impress his client. Emphasize with the anxieties faced by the artist in not being able to experiment with his artistic sensibilities, cubism or modern art. Let us read and understand the text. Glossary. Monsieur. French. In French, for monsieur we call as Mr. Patron. A person who supports artists and writers. Sent. Means called. Signor means Mr. Monsieur Sinilabé had been a master artist of his day, and in 1392 was ready to retire when in the month of May, Giuliano Bartoli, a rich Italian patron, called for him. On his arrival, Bartoli said, "I would like a portrait of myself on the wall of my dining hall, where everyone can see it. Could you paint it? The wall is 20 feet tall." Monsieur Labbé looked thoughtfully for a moment and then shook his head. "I'm sorry, but I don't think so. I'm ready to retire and so I'm not able for hire." However, seeing the disappointment in Signor Bartoli's eyes, he continued, "Well, there's a possibility if you think you can allow me to use my abilities to the fullest. If you let me find how far I can go as an artist. Not for money, mind you, but for food and a bed instead. You need not even pose because my memo's excellent. Already, I can see your portrait in my mind. But I insist, Signor Bartoli, that while I work, your portrait must remain hidden, even from you." So you have seen that Monsieur Sinilabé is a master artist and who is a rich Italian patron, children. The rich Italian patron is Giuliano Bartoli. He wanted his portrait to be made on a 20 feet tall wall so that everybody can see his wall. At first, Sinilabé did not agree to make his portrait. And then later on, seeing the disappointment in Signor Bartoli's eyes, he agreed to do. Before he agreed, he made some conditions. He said that he wants to put his own ideas in making the portrait. He said that he doesn't want any money, but he just want some food and bed to sleep. He said that by the time he complete his portrait, it should be hidden. It should be even hidden from him. It should be a complete privacy. Paragraph 3 to 5. Glossary. Recommended. Express a good opinion of. Insist. Take a firm stand. glint, sudden brightness in the eyes, showing happiness or excitement. Gazed, look at with fixed eyes. Give his imagination wings. Allow his imagination to work freely so that he could paint the portrait the way he liked. Hunger to break free of restraints. Wanted badly to break free from traditional art forms. Guild, a professional union of artists or craftsmen, which was quite powerful. Reveal, make visible. Paragraph 3. How strange, thought the patron. But he also thought about how highly the artist has been recommended. Of course, he said, anything you wish, but I insist upon paying you at least something for your effort. Let's draw up a contract. What did Batroli say? He said that no, at least I'll pay you something or the other for your hard work. Paragraph 4. Now a glint came to Monsieur Labby's eyes as he gazed upon the 20-foot wall and thought of that space. Such a wonderful space to give his imagination wings, to think on his own. Because, unknown to Signor Bettoli, or indeed anyone else, for all of his career of 45 years, Monsieur Labbé had longed to paint in his own way. And what way was that? Certainly not the popular style of his time. No, Monsieur Signy Labbé had hunger to break free of restraints. That means he didn't want to follow the traditional art forms. But the guilt, his craft and the livelihood would never have allowed it. So he followed their rules, although he was never proud of it. Of course, he did not reveal this to Signor Bettoli. The type of picture, the portrait he wanted to make, he did not tell anything about that portrait to Bettoli. He just wanted to do the portrait on his own, put his own imagination and wanted it to be in full privacy. Why he wanted it to be in full privacy? Because he may think that Bettoli may like the portrait or may not like the portrait or come and disturb him. He didn't want any suggestions from anyone because he always longed to make a portrait on himself. From how many years he had that desire? He had that desire from 45 years. And so finally, he got a chance to make a portrait on himself. Signing the contract, they sealed the agreement. Glossary. Apprentice. A person who works for an employer mainly to learn the skills required for a particular job. Ambrigo Lorenzetti. An Italian painter who worked in the 14th century and was one of the most important painters of his time. Grinding means mixing. What is the meaning of pigment? Colored powder that is mixed with liquid to produce paint. Plaster. A mixture of sand and cement put on walls and ceilings to give them a smooth surface. Now let us read paragraph 6 to 9. Immediately the master artist threw a high curtain in front of the wall. A curtain through which Signor Bettoli could not see at all. He tried to peek, but Monsieur Labbé insisted on total privacy for his artistic techniques. Slowly, slowly a week passed. How is it coming? Asked hopeful Signor Bettoli. Answering him from behind the curtain, Monsieur Labbé said, it's coming along quite well. You know, at the age of 8, I was apprenticed to the great Ambrigo Lorenzetti. Means, a person who works for an employer mainly to learn skills. From whom did he learn skills? He learned from an Italian painter who was very famous at that time and his name is Ambrigo Lorenzetti. I could never dishonor his name. He taught me the art of grinding pigment, laying plaster, sometimes slowly, sometimes faster. He taught me how to draw and most importantly, not to hurry. Signor Bettoli, a masterpiece, takes a while at least. Reluctantly, Signor Bertoli withdrew. Glossary. Buon fresco, an Italian expression for true fresco. Fresco is a technique of painting in which a picture is painted on a wall or ceiling while the plaster is still wet so that the colors blend with the plaster and become fixed as the plaster dries. Endeavor, effort or activity. Sighing, breathing, breathe heavily. Paragraph 10 to 12. A month passed before a week passed, but the portrait was not completed. Slowly, slowly, days passed and even a month was passed. Again, Signor Bertoli came and asked to Sini Labbe, "How is it coming along?" "It's coming along nicely," Monsieur Labbe said, again from behind the curtain. Along with his words came the strange sounds of whooshing, clanking and slapping. "You know you are fortunate that I am painting your portrait," said Sini Labbe from behind the curtain. "Only Buon Fresco will need 4 coats of lime plaster. It's the best plaster process I ever saw, Signor Bertoli. It will last forever, but it's a time-consuming endeavor." He says that I'm using such type of techniques so that the portrait will last forever, but this will take time. It's a time-consuming task. Again, breathing deeply and heavily, the patron withdrew again. He left from that place. "Just how long would this take?" he asked. Paragraph 13 to 15, glossary. Exclaimed means shouted, grabbed, pulled. A twitch, a brief, sudden movement that showed his anger, enraged, furious. Paragraph 13 to 15. Let us read and understand. Another 3 months, another 4 months was passed, and finally half a year went by. That means 6 months was completed. One day, Signor Bertoli marched in, demanding of Monsieur Labbe, the master artist, to see his portrait. Now he could not wait anymore. So directly he marched inside and said that he wanted to see his portrait. "You must be finished by now and today I will see it," he said. "You must have finished it by now and now I am not going to wait anymore. Show me my portrait," he exclaimed, shaking with frustration. He was very angry and could not wait anymore. Stepping from behind the cloth as though surprised by such anger, Monsieur Labbe said, "Calm down, that's fine. You needed only to request it." And he pulled aside the 20-foot tall curtain. Finally, the curtain was removed from the wall. And now, let us see how did Giuliano Bertoli reacted after seeing the portrait. Giuliano Bertoli stood for a minute. Then his mouth fell open. His eyes turned red and he grabbed what few hairs he had left on his head. He did a little hop and then a twitch, and his eyebrows twisted as though he was under a spell. Giuliano Bertoli obviously did not like his portrait, not a bit. Giuliano Bertoli enraged. See, this is how he reacted when he saw his portrait on his wall, on a 20-foot wall. He was expecting something else, but it ended in another way in which he became very angry. Para 16 to 18, glossary. Absurd means ridiculous. Sight, view, first and fixed, thought and worked on it before finalizing. Cubist, belonging to a style called cubism, a form of modern art which uses geometric shapes and was developed and made famous by Pablo Picasso in the early 20th century. This story tells us an artist who lived 505 centuries earlier had discovered the same style and received no recognition for doing so. Let us read paragraph 16 to 18. How absurd, how disgusting. What does this mean? You will not receive any money. You hear? None. You are not an artist. You may be a thief or a madman. Get out of my sight. You leave my house tonight or I'll have to throw you out from here. So what had Monsieur l'Abbé drawn that was so wrong? Do you think was it wrong? He could not see it. He would first and fixed for so long. It was his 20-foot tall masterpiece. He wasn't sorry that he had drawn to his heart's content his way, no matter what anybody would say. Perhaps his patron could not tolerate his cubist expression, but Pablo Picasso would have been proud of him. If truth be told, Monsieur l'Abbé wasn't crazy at all. He's simply been born 500 years too early. Actually, Sini l'Abbé didn't feel bad when Bartoli got angry on him. He just thought that anyhow he got a chance to paint the portrait on his own, for which he was waiting for long years, that is 45 years. So he was not crazy, children. He just made a painting of a modern style which was not liked by Bartoli. I hope you all understood the lesson. Lesson summary. In the year 1392, the master artist of his time, Monsieur l'Abbé, was ready to retire when Giuliano Bartoli, a rich patron, wanted his portrait on the 20 feet high wall in his dining hall where everyone can see him. At first, Monsieur l'Abbé refused, but seeing the disappointment on Bartoli's face, he agreed, but on the condition that l'Abbé can explore the limits of his abilities. He said that he don't want money but food and bed instead. He said that the portrait must remain hidden from everyone, even from Bartoli. The initial rejection on seeing the canvas, that is the 20 feet tall wall, turned to a willing acceptance when Sini l'Abbé was struck by a unique thought. Giuliano Bartoli accepted both the conditions laid down by Sini l'Abbé with slight modifications, and a contract was signed. For all of his career of 40 years, Monsieur l'Abbé had longed to paint in his own way. Immediately, the master artist threw a high curtain in front of the wall, through which Signor Bartoli could not see at all. However, Giuliano Bartoli was curious to know the painting was coming along and tried to catch a glimpse of it many times, but failed. After a half year had passed, the patron could not resist seeing the painting. So he firmly declared to Signor l'Abbé that he is coming on the other side of the curtain to view the painting. The artist crumbled to the patron's word and pulled aside the curtain, feeling proud of his creation. But the patron was red with anger. He asked l'Abbé to get out of his house without any payment before he was thrown out. So what had Monsieur l'Abbé drawn was so wrong? He did not mind his patron's response because he had painted as he had always desired, putting his heart and soul in his painting. He was happy that at last he was able to realize his dream and paint his masterpiece in the cubist style. Thank you, children.